sure you have heard about big data enough times. So let me start with few success stories, right? So I'll just talk about one or two. So the one very curious case was that basically they took some biopsy data, images, and they were basically running machine learning algorithms on top of that to detect anomalies. And they found two errors, right? And when they looked at it in a lot of detail, they figured all 12 were correct. However, only the doctors only knew 9, right? So, like so those kind of research make you think the power and the promise around this, right? And there are like a lot of other use cases, of course, this Moneyball use case, etc. So I'll one more, which is that actually Kruger, US retail supermarket company, they were one of the companies who started the these loyalty programs like very early. So they had shown like 45 quarters of growth, consecutive growth, which I mean not an easy thing to do, right? So these says, okay, then now this example showed the big data can be useful, right? At least in certain settings. I think the what we are trying to discuss is how would it help you or for your organization in your context, right? Because it's shown that in specific context it has been useful. Now in very simple terms, the promise of big data is that if you collect data about your organization, your process, whatever you are doing, and analyze it, it'll give you useful insights that'll improve things. Okay? So, now if you think about it, why would that improve things? Actually, because there's an underlying assumption which people don't explicitly say. There's an assumption that there are inefficiencies, right? Basically, what big data promises you is much detailed visibility into what's going on, right? So it helps because there are underlying inefficiencies. Like, for example, the actual world is pretty inefficient place. Like, for example, like it's generally considered like something between 1/3 to 1/2 of all food get wasted, so on and so forth, right? So you could think as big data is like a profiler for your organization. It gives you visibility so that you understand what's going on and improve things. Okay? So, however, like, for example, if you are a programmer who has used a profiler, you would know that blindly applying a profiler won't help you, right? You have to know what's worth optimizing, right? So this tells that you have to think, you have to approach this very carefully and thoughtfully, right? So I'm sure you know what this term means, right? So let's say you are CEO, your supervisor, and tell you that, oh, make sure by end of this year we are using big data, or we are somehow using big data. Actually, doing that is not that hard, right? So, if you want to do that, this one way to do that, right? Just collect some data, right? Just aggregate few things, right? Do some pretty pictures. It's not that hard to do, like collect and do some pretty pictures. Predict something, right? And show a very nice demo. And claim there's a lot you can do, right? Okay, so however, it's not that easy. I mean, you could do this, you could tick saying it's done. However, whether it'll make a difference, it depends, right? So it might help if you have the right data, if you are analyzing the right problem, right? If what you are looking for is there, and if you look that hard enough, right? So basically, you need to look at it in a lot more carefully, right? So let's try to work through this problem, right? So this picture shows some of the places where big data can help an organization, right? So it goes from like improving internal efficiencies, customer service, creating new products, right? The brand management, social media, you are maintaining the operations of sites, etc., supply chain, so on and so forth, right? So there are a lot of use cases, but you need to understand what of these use cases might applicable and make a difference in your case, right? Because only if the brand image is very useful for your business, it might worth spending a lot of money. But if your business is like certain business where the word basically the good word said by your customers will give you a lot of business, like restaurants, advertisement might not help you that much, right? So of course you could do these things, but you need to think very carefully. Does that make sense? Does that help my underlying problem? Right? So there are, like, when you try to do big data, there are several different concepts, right? You can think these are different tools. These are things that you could combine in different ways. So let's try to walk through and see what they do, right? And then let's try to come back and say, okay, if you want to do something useful, what you want to do. Right? So the first thing is the KPIs, or key performance indicators. So the best example of this is that people who do mining, actually, especially in UK, like there was a lot of coal mines, etc., they used to take the canaries, this small bird, into the mine, because if the oxygen level is less, it'll knock out the bird very, very fast. And you know, if the bird get knocked out, you should be going out very, very fast. Okay? So that's a KPI. The KPI is something that indicates the current performance of your system. Okay? So the very famous KPIs are things like GDP, per capita index, etc. These are KPIs of a country, right? There are others, like if you take a company, the company revenue, lifetime value of a customer, revenue per square foot, like in retail, that's the number, and that's one of the very important numbers they look at, right? So the KPIs, but they depend on domain to domain. However, in whatever the domain you are in, those KPIs very likely already defined. Otherwise, you may have to do a lot of work to define them, right? So the KPIs, this tells what really matters for your organization, for your business, right? So that's the place to start, right? So the one more catch is that very often one KPI won't tell the full story. I mean, I'm sure you have heard that the GDP do not tell everything about a country, although it is a useful indicator. So you also need to know that these KPIs you have to interpret holistically, not just looking at the number, right? So, okay. The second tool in your toolbox is dashboards, right? If you want to think about the dashboard, think of your car dashboard. We all know that if the car dashboard shows some red color things, that's not good, right? So the goal of a dashboard is to be very, very boring when things are good, but start flashing things when something is wrong. A good dashboard would tell you whether things are good or bad in one glance. Okay? So then a good dashboard should let you, when there's a problem, it should let you drill down and find out what's the problem. Cars don't have that, but software you can, right? So this is the second tool. This is a dashboard that if you are applying big data, you can have a dashboard that shows how your organization is doing, which is very boring if everything is good, but start flashing when something interesting happens. The third case is alerts, right? So alerts are when something very, very interesting happens, it'll let you know. Okay? So if you are the guy who receives the alerts, actually that might be source of a lot of stress for you. Right? Because you never know when it'll turn up, right? However, the goal of alerts is give you peace of mind so that you don't have to keep checking the dashboard, keep looking at the keep your eyeballs on the dashboard. However, if you have too many alerts, it completely breaks the process because your people would be unhappy because they get bugged all the time, and because of now it's playing the crying wolf, when actually the problem happens, they won't react. Right? So the good alert should be very specific, very infrequent, and should have very less number of false positives. Okay? So that's the third tool. Then, when you think about these big data systems, the systems you build generally should have a human in the loop. So for some use cases, like for example, Next thermostat, okay, so if it mess up, okay, the worst case is you will sweat a bit. Hopefully it won't bake you, right? So there are some use cases where you don't need a human in the loop, but if you are doing critical things, you generally need the human in the loop because the unexpected things can happen, right? Then, as I said before, the goal of this big data system is to help you take decisions and to know details, right? So that means you start with alert in a dashboard. However, when you have alert, you need to be able to tell why it happens, what happens around it, what, for example, if it is a transaction, what are the other steps? What was the specific customer request that led to this problem? What kind of customer, like as we discussed in the morning, right? I mean, if you are an airline and if a gold passenger is somehow unhappy, maybe you need to do something. Like all this context is also very important, right? Because that in one side gives you the confidence to the end user about your system. Also, it let him act intelligently and not do stupid things, right? So then there are two technologies that are on top of base analytics. There are some use cases where the value of the information diminishes with time, right? For example, like if somebody is going to get a heart attack, you would want to know it right now, right? I mean, it's interesting to discuss that the next day, but it's a curiosity by the end, right? So there's technology called real-time analytics that let you take decisions from data very, very fast. They are a bit more complicated. Now, this is not for everything. Some use cases, you don't need that. However, if you need that, like the heart attack I was talking about, then you can use it. Then the next, another one, is that when you work through these use cases, you will run into some use cases where it's very hard to list down how it should act, right? To give you an example. Now, if I ask you to write a program, right, that predicts how the temperature would change over in the future, you could try to do something, but it's very, very hard to get that right because, so you could make it like 80% correct pretty easily, but rest is very, very hard because there are a lot of conditions that very hard to think, analyze through. But there's technology, I mean, we also call this machine learning. So this technology let you give lot of example data and let the computer learn the logic of predicting. So it look at the data and it'll figure out a function that best describe how it would change. Right? So this, because we work most of these decisions, we work with very there are very complicated conditions and uncertainty. The machine learning could play a huge role. Okay, so now, so putting these together, a typical big data pipeline would look like that, right? So you would start with the data set. You would explore to understand what that data set means, right? Then you define KPIs, okay? Then basically you would set up a system that continue to collect the data, calculate important KPIs, and visualize them through dashboards, right? And when these KPIs had changed in interesting ways, you would create alerts, and when an alert happens, the person who get the alert or who would see in the dashboard some interesting behavior, they could drill down and understand what's going on. And finally, on top of that, you could use predictive analytics to not only react to what's going on right now and trying to predict what can happen. And for example, like take traffic, right? So actually if you, okay, I daily do a 1 hour commute. Generally within like first 5 minutes, you know, okay, it'll be 1 hour or 2 hours because, I mean, you know if certain places are blocked, it'll be a nightmare from that point, right? It's like that. If you have enough data and if you can analyze that, very often you could tell that, oh, that means there'll be huge traffic in another 1 hour or so, I should start acting. Start to change what's going to happen. Okay, so I think it's very, very important to keep this story in your mind when you build a system, because this would make sure that what you build would be useful end to end. Okay? And very, very important another point is that whatever inside that production box, right? So those are the things that keep happening. They are very expensive. Okay? So basically you need a system, you want to set up, you want DevOps, you want people looking at it, etc. So don't do that part until you figure out what is useful for you, until you know what are the KPIs, until you have some idea how would affect your bottom line. Okay? So, and then if you want to keep the system running, deploy it and keep it running, it gets much more complicated because you would now get more data. Like, how would you get this data into your system continuously, right? How often should you update your models, right? Now, let's say you generate an alert which was not correct. You could give a button to the end user saying this was wrong. Can I get that feedback into my system so that it won't happen again or reduce the probability of it's happening again, right? So all these things come into play. Okay? So if you are trying to do a big, like start a big data project, so try to explore and understand what's the inefficiency that will solve in your system. Right? So these are like different ways to do like big data projects. For example, you could start with existing data set. You might have some data. You could start with that and try to analyze it. So that's one option. Another option is you could understand the business use cases and find a point where there are a lot of inefficiencies. Find the existing problem. Do what you need to try to address that one. Right, and build a thin slice that see whether it works. The third approach is that basically you could go and start instrumenting your system, right? So that you will have more data, right? So the fourth one, basically you could collect whatever you can and try to see the connection. However, in my opinion, you should start with number two, right? Because it has a very high chance that you would, whatever you do, if successful, would have an impact on the bottom line. It's most likely you could very easily make a case. Look, it solved this problem, so invest into this, right? Because the other ones, for example, number three, like say that collect whatever the data you can, basically means you will spend a lot of money, right? But like after a year or so, if the CEO asks you, okay, what's the impact on the bottom line? There might be nothing. There may be things in the future, but so it's a very, if you, that's the part that gets the project killed, right? So, try to like find the pain point and build your system around it, because then you would have a very good case going forward, right? So the key is that what they call actionable insights, right? So these are significant events that warrant attention, okay? So you need to detect, so whatever you detect or whatever you alert, there has to be significant, right? It has to make a difference at the end of the day. And you have to show the decision makers the why it happens, the context, what happens around it. The third thing is that the decision, there has to be something you could do about that, right? I'm sure. So there's this very famous economist called I forgot the name. So he he basically said that so that before him, people are you looking at when they analyze economics, they were thinking very long term. Then this economist said that in the long term, we all dead. Because if you think, if you analyze like that, we all dead, but there's nothing there's nothing we can do with our technology right now do about it, right? So that kind of insights, although it's useful, yes, if you can fix it, there's like huge impact, but nothing you can do, right? So you don't need that kind of insights, right? So it should be, it need these three things, which is that these are significant, you could understand what's going on, third, you can do something about that, okay? And finally, think how whoever the end user would use this thing. So basically, you want to identify a incident, receive an alert, then go and understand why this happens, and understand what are other things related to this. How confident you know about this decision, then act on that result, and if it doesn't work well, give feedback saying, oh, you give me this thing, it didn't work. At least it'll improve next time. Okay? So to summarize, the big data is a way to, the promise of big data is that it would improve efficiency in your system, right? So it to be useful, you had to figure out where the problems are, right? So we talk about these tools, right? We talk about different parts of big data, how they fit into your story, where basically dashboard, alerts, drill down, etc. How does it flow through? Start small, work on a very specific use case, right, figure out KPIs, etc. with the data, right? Only when you have, like, you can establish the usefulness, go for production, right? Don't invest on a huge systems until you prove the value, right? Because generally that approach gets the project killed. Thank you.